everybody, happy 2020. That is still so weird to say. I hope you all are having an amazing start to your new year. And I just thought I would make this video. I know it's been a while since I have sat down with you all, but I was thinking that I made this video exactly a year ago talking about my New Year's resolutions and just a life update in general. So I thought I would go ahead and do that again for you all. So much has happened in this past year, and I just thought we would share our excitement of 2020 together. I genuinely have such a good feeling about this year. I think it's going to be a big year for a lot of us. For me personally, this is the first year that I really have no idea what's in store for me even 3 months from now, which terrifies me, but also it excites me not knowing exactly a mapped out plan like I have my entire life. So I am currently in the process of trying to figure things out down the road. I recently set in stone some exciting goals that I will go into more detail about in this video. And I just love going back and forth about New Year's resolutions and getting ideas from other people. So that's why I love creating this type of video. It just gets me excited for the new year, because if you're anything like me, you go through the January, February blues where it's after Christmas, it's still freezing outside, you're in the dead of winter, and I think a lot of people can slip into a depression in January and February. So I think having these visions for the new year are so important and get you excited about the coming months. So that's what we're going to talk about today. Let's get started. If you watched my video from last year, two of my main New Year's resolutions were to read a book a month and to run a lot more and maintain being active. Ever since I graduated college, I am no longer a college cheerleader, so I really wanted to keep that up, some form of physical activity. So running was that for me, and I really wanted to challenge myself because I have never viewed myself as a runner before. I still don't see myself as a serious runner, but honestly, it has, not to be dramatic, but it really has been life-changing in that it has given me so much more assurance in myself that I can do anything I set my mind to. And the same goes for any of you watching this, because if I can run 10 miles like I did a few days ago, you can too. I promise you that, as long as you practice dedication and self-discipline. And actually, the next video that I have planned is going to explain exactly why I'm running long distance. And it has to do with a certain dream of mine that I am pursuing in less than 2 months. Actually, it's next month. Oh my gosh, that's crazy. And I am so excited to share that with you all in the next video. But getting back to my first resolution about reading a book a month, I am happy to report that I accomplished that goal, and I have my pile of books right here. And I just wanted to recommend some books for you all. I'm gonna choose my top five out of the 12 that I read. I don't know if you can see all this, but these are my books that I read, starting from the bottom with January and going all the way to the top with December. Yeah, maybe you guys recognize some of these books and have read them yourselves or have heard about them. All 12 books were well worth my time, and I strongly recommend all of them to you, but I will go ahead and tell you my top five, and they are Everybody Always by Bob Goff, Jesus is Greater Than Religion by Jefferson Bethke, Preach to Yourself by Haley Morgan, Kisses from Katie by Katie Davis, and Rhythms of Renewal by Rebecca Lyons. These books truly were life-changing to me. Each have such beautiful messages that I hope will always be instilled in my heart for the rest of my life, because they truly are such wonderful books, and each author is just incredible. So highly recommend those, and I'm excited to say that I'm going to continue that resolution this year, because my book list is still forever long. I'm sure a lot of you can relate, but it feels so good to finally check off books on your list that have been just on your bookshelf for forever, it seems like. So I'm really looking forward to continuing that with even more books, and if you all have any book recommendations, I would love to hear them in the comments below. And as far as the rest of my 2020 resolutions go, I divided them up into three categories, the first being personal, and then life, and work. So I'll give you some examples of the ones I wrote down in each of the categories, so maybe it could help you kind of clarify them and have them a little more organized. I know it helps me feel a little better to not have a jumbled list of all of my 2020 resolutions. So for personal, my main personal resolution is to pray for guidance every night. I never have really had a word for a year. I know a lot of people do that. I've never done it before, but I guess my word for this year, if I had to have one, would be guidance, because like I mentioned earlier, I really have no idea what is in store for this year, but I just have this assurance and this strong sense that something exciting is going to happen this year, and I don't know what it is, but I am just so ready to see what God has in store for all of us. So praying for guidance every night is a really important resolution for me. As some of you may know, my faith is my entire life. Being a follower of Christ is of the utmost importance to me. And to be completely honest, I haven't been practicing my faith as much as I want to. And what I mean by that is I haven't been staying in constant communication with God. I have barely cracked open my Bible recently. And these things don't make God love you more or less. But, you know, doing those things does make you closer to God, and God has, you know, is always pursuing you no matter what, but I haven't been pursuing God like I want to. And so this year, above everything else, I really want to focus on that and just creating space and time for God, because He should be my number one priority. And sometimes I really put other things before Him, and I want to change that. So I just want to be open and honest with you all, and I challenge you to do the same thing if you feel kind of like you're in the same boat as I am. Really get quiet with God and see what exactly it is that you think you need to specifically pray for. And I would love to pray for you if you would like to message me. I would absolutely love to pray for you. So that's my number one resolution, is just praying for guidance every night. Like I said, another personal goal is to run long distance, and I'm up to 10 miles right now, so I still have a few more miles to go, but I've been really pleased with my progress. Another one is to read before bed, so that's kind of part of my a book a month plan, instead of just, you know, being on the computer or my phone or anything like that. Another personal goal of mine is to be off of social media for 3 months. So I started as soon as the clock struck midnight on December 31st. So starting January 1st until April 1st, I am off of Instagram and Facebook, which are the main ones I have ever used anyway. I don't really use Facebook. I have to use it for work, but that's the only time I ever use social media. And I don't really consider YouTube social media. I consider it more of entertainment, like Netflix or something. So obviously I'm going to be posting this on my YouTube channel, but mainly Instagram. I just felt like I really needed this break, and I think it's good for everyone to take a break from Instagram and social media in general, just to kind of get some clarity and get time away from your phone and to focus on what really matters, what life is really about. And I just felt like I didn't have as much substance in my life as I need, and I was not getting that from Instagram, and I was going to social media to be fulfilled in ways that only God can fulfill. So I think it's just healthy to take those breaks for yourself. And of course, a lot of Instagram is about comparison, and that can really steal a lot of your joy. So I think it is just really good to step away from that for a while. And so I'm actually excited to be taking a break from it. Another one is to learn more about cooking. Yeah, I love food. I love to cook, but I still have a lot to learn. So that's definitely one I want to focus on. I have a daily devotional by Bob Goff that I have been reading every morning before work, and I am so not a morning person, so It's really important to me to start my days off right by taking a few minutes each morning to just fully devote to reading my daily devotional, and it has already helped my days go so much better just to have your heart in the right place. Another one is to start a prayer journal, which, you know, I just was talking about earlier with prayer requests and everything, just to kind of look back and see where I was at a certain point in my life, what exactly I was praying for, and even praying for other people. I think it's really important to remember those prayers and to jot them down. Another one is to go to therapy. I have never been to therapy before, and again, this is something that I just want to be really transparent with you all about. I think everyone should go to therapy. The stigma needs to die for good, that there's something wrong with you if you have to go to therapy, because that is so far from the truth. You know, we go to the gym to exercise our bodies. We need to go to a counselor to exercise our minds and to learn about ourselves more, you know, why we do things, why we are the way we are. I think it's really important to check in with ourselves and to be self-aware. So that can be done with going to a therapist, and it's just about being mentally healthy. So I'm really excited to finally start to do that. I've been wanting to do it for a long time now, so I am ready to do that this year, finally. Okay, so those are my personal ones. So some of my life resolutions are to have a game night each week. I love board games, so either, or even like a puzzle or something to do with my mom or some of my friends. I think that would be so much fun to do, just to get off of our phones and just fully have that time together. Another one, I have an app called, let's see, I don't know if you can see this on here. Ooh. It's called 1SE, 1 second every day. I think that's what it stands for. But you take a little video clip of 1 second each day. And you know how sentimental I am. And obviously I love to take videos. So I think it'll be so cool. And I've seen people do it before. I've always wanted to do this. And so you can look back at your entire year within like 6 minutes, all accumulated from 365 seconds. So yeah, I think that's a really neat idea. Sometimes it's gonna be a struggle. Like today, I really don't know what to film. I might film like me filming this video, but another one is to go somewhere new. I think I'll do that one every year as a resolution. And then for work, as some of you all know, my ultimate work dream is to work for the Disney company again, but kind of as more of the behind the scenes in the communications and marketing field, which is what I graduated with my Bachelor of Arts degree in. And I am so excited to announce, this is what I was talking about earlier of taking some steps of setting certain things in stone. I was recently accepted into Liberty University's Master of Arts Strategic Communications program, and I am so thrilled to be starting classes in a few days. I can't believe it, and I will be done by spring of next year. So I already know my set schedule, all the classes I'm going to be taking. It's completely online, and I'm so excited to get my master's degree. This is something I've been kind of on the fence about for a while now, but I really want to get serious about my work goals and just to further my passion in this field of marketing and communications. So I am really looking forward to that, and I will let you all know how that goes. So a few of my other work-related goals have to do with tailoring my cover letters to each application I send in, sprucing up my online portfolio, which I've already done, and my resume. Just, it's so important to stay up to date on that, because if you have new jobs and you kind of lose track of like, oh, specific tasks I did and I don't remember exactly what they were, it's so important to just kind of fill that in as you go with each job. So learned that lesson. I'm caught up on that, and yeah, I'm still pursuing some work goals there too. But those are my 2020 resolutions. Oh, and one more, one super random goal that I have is to, I guess, what would this go under? I guess it would go under life,
Yeah, life resolution.
I'm learning to play the ukulele. This is the beautiful one I fell in love with on Amazon and I asked for Christmas. So I am going to be self-taught. I already tuned it myself and I'm just learning from videos on YouTube. I'm being super cheap about it. But yeah, I can barely strum. So that's where I am right now. And I've learned the basic chords. This is the A chord. And then this is the C chord. And then, oh gosh. F chord. And then, I think that's right. And then this. And this is, I can't remember. This might be the F chord. I don't know. See, I'm definitely still in the very beginning stages. But, oh my gosh, so bad. But I'm just really excited to learn something new. I think that's really important to just do things with your hands, whether it's creating something or, like I said, playing an instrument or whatever. I would love to learn the lava song eventually on my ukulele, but I think what I'm really learning with this is just practicing patience with myself, because I really struggle with patience. So this is not only teaching me how to play a string instrument, but also teaching me an important life lesson. So there you have it. Those are my New Year's resolutions / a life update. Still more life updates to come very soon. There are some plans in the near future, but there are still things that are completely up in the air for this year, and I am just thrilled to see where God takes me on my life path this year. And I hope you all have an amazing 2020 and that you will be able to stick to your New Year's resolutions as well. Something I learned, I'll kind of leave you with this, and this is what helped me stick to my two main resolutions last year, is being very specific with your goals. So instead of saying, I want to be more active, you can say, I want to run a 5K. I think it's really important to set like certain numbers, or like with the books, like instead of saying, I want to read more, I said, I want to read 12 books in a year. I want to read a book a month. So things like that, just giving yourself an exact measurement to reach makes you feel more accomplished, because if you're vague about your goals, you never really know when you hit them. So I think it really motivates you when you set specific goals and you make them very tangible and write them down, please. I have them in the notes of my phone. You can put them in a journal or a planner, anything you want. And also do step-by-step mini goals for your main goal, so that you can check them off on the way and you can actually track your progress. So those are my tips about New Year's resolutions. And again, I hope you all have a wonderful year and I will see you very soon. Have a magical night.